let us learn about the topic fundamental theorem of arithmetic. So in your earlier classes you already know how to factorize a composite number into its prime factors, or a composite number can be expressed as the product of prime factors. So for example, take 60. So we can factorize 60. So it is divisible by 2, then it is divisible by 2 also, then 3, 5. So 60 can be written as 2 multiplied with 2 multiplied with 3 multiplied with 5. So 60 is equal to 2 to the power 2 multiplied with 3 multiplied with 5. So this is the prime factorization of 60. So take another example, 210. So this is equal to, so 210, first it is divisible by 2, then it is divisible by 3, then it is divisible by 5, 7. So then 7 is a prime number. So 210 is equal to 2 multiplied with 3 multiplied with 5 multiplied with 7. Then come to another example, 360. So what is the prime factorization of 360? So you take 360. So first it is divisible by 2, then 180, then it is also divisible by 2, 90, then divisible by 2, 45, then 3, 15, 3, 5. So the prime factorization of 360 is equal to 2 multiplied with 2 multiplied with 2 multiplied with 3 multiplied with 3 multiplied with 5. So this can be written as 2 to the power 3 multiplied with 3 to the power 2 multiplied with 5. So take another example, 32760. So it is divisible by 2. So 2, 1, 6, 3, 8, 0. So again this is divisible by 2. 8, 1, 9, 0. Again it is divisible by 2. 4, 0, 9, 5. Then this is divisible by 3. 3, 1, 3, then 3, 6, 5. Then it is also divisible by 3. 4, 3, 4 are 12, then 3, 5, 5. Then it is divisible by 5. 9, 1. Then it is divisible by 7, 13. So 3, 2, 7, 6, 0 is equal to 2 multiplied with 2 multiplied with 2 multiplied with 3 multiplied with 3 multiplied with 5 multiplied with 7 multiplied with 3. So this becomes 2 to the power 3 multiplied with 3 to the power 2 multiplied with 5 multiplied with 7 multiplied with 3. So this is the prime factorization of 32760. From all the examples, we conclude that every composite number can be factorized as the product of prime factors. Then, if we multiply the prime numbers, that will become also a composite number. Like, if we multiply 2 multiplied with 3, that is equal to 6. So, 6 is a composite number. So, 2 multiplied with 3 multiplied with 11. 11 is a prime number, so this becomes 66. So this is the prime factorization of composite number. Theorem of arithmetic is every composite number can be expressed or factorized as a product of primes, and this factorization is unit apart from the order in which the prime factors occur. So take an example that we have solved for 210. So 210 is equal to 2 multiplied with 3 multiplied with 5 multiplied with 7. this factorization is unique. No other way we will factorize 210. But the order may be changed. This can be written as like this. 3 multiplied with 5 multiplied with 2 multiplied with 7. This can be written as also 3 multiplied with 7 multiplied with 5 multiplied with 2. So whatever the order may be, but the factorization should be unique. Factorization is unique. So let us solve one example. So find the LCM and HCF of 6 and 20 by the prime factorization method. So first you factorize 6. So 6 is equal to 2 multiplied with 3. Then factorize 20. 20 is equal to 2 multiplied with 2 multiplied with 5. So this is equal to 2 to the power 2 multiplied with 5. So first we have to find HCF. So what is HCF? First find the common factor. So in these two numbers, in these two factorization, so common factor is 2. But here the power is 1 and here the power is 2. So to find HCF, we should take the lowest power of the common factor, or the product of the lowest power of common factors present in this number. So HCF is equal to 2. So this is order is degree is 1. So we have to take 2 as HCF. Then what is LCM? So LCM is the product of highest power of the factors, prime factors present in the numbers. All the prime factors we have to take, but the highest power should multiply. So here 2 power is 1, here 2 power is 2. So we have to take 2 to the power 2. So here 3 to the power 1, here 3 to the power 0. So 1 is the highest, so we have to take 3. So here also 5 to the power 1, here 5 to the power 0, so we have to take 5. So the answer is 4 multiplied with 3 multiplied with 5. The answer is 60. So the LCM is 60 and the HCF is 2. So another rule is there. For any two positive integers a and b, HCF of a and b multiplied with LCM of a and b is equal to product of a and b. So in our previous example, we have found that HCF of 6 and 20 is 2 and LCM of 6 and 20 we have found it, that is 60. So then verify this rule. So HCF multiplied with LCM, that means 2 multiplied with 60 is equal to, our two numbers are 6 multiplied with 20. So 120 is equal to 120. So this rule is verified by taking this example. So our second example is, find the HCF of 96 and 404 by the prime factorization method, hence find the LCM. So first we will find the HCF by prime factorization method. So first you factorize 96. So 96 divided by 2, 48. Again you divided by 2, that is 24. Then by 2, 12. Then by 2, that is 6. Then by 2, it is 3. So 96 is equal to 2 to the power 5 multiplied with 3. Again our next number is 404. So 404, it is divisible by 2. 2 2's are 4, 0, 2. Then 2, 1, 0, 1. So 1, 0, 1 is a prime number. So 404 is equal to 2 to the power 2 multiplied with 101. So what is the HCF? So HCF of 96 and 404 is equal to the product of कॉमन प्राइम फैक्टर्स और प्रोडक्ट ऑफ कॉमन प्राइम फैक्टर्स विथ लोएस्ट पावर. सो हियर टू पावर इज 5 एंड हियर पावर इज 2. सो वी हैव टू टेक द लोएस्ट पावर. सो 2 टू द पावर 2 दैट इज इक्वल टू 4. सो आवर एलसीएम इज 4. सो नेक्स्ट क्वेश्चन इज फाइंड द एलसीएम. सो द क्वेश्चन इज नॉट आस्क्ड टू फाइंड द एलसीएम बाय प्राइम फैक्टराइजेशन मेथड. सो वी हैव टू फाइंड एलसीएम फ्रॉम द रूल दैट एलसीएम मल्टीप्लाइड विथ एलसीएम इज इक्वल टू प्रोडक्ट ऑफ टू नंबर्स. सो एलसीएम मल्टीप्लाइड विथ एचसीएफ इज इक्वल टू प्रोडक्ट. सो दिस इंप्लाइज एलसीएम इज इक्वल टू प्रोडक्ट दैट आवर टू नंबर्स इज 96 मल्टीप्लाइड विथ 404 डिवाइडेड बाई एचसीएफ इज 4. सो दिस बिकम्स 24 मल्टीप्लाइड विथ 404. सो दिस बिकम्स 9696. So this is our LCM. So our third example is find the HCF and LCM of 672 and 120 by prime factorization method. So here we have three numbers. So we have to factorize all. So first 6. We know that 6 is equal to 2 multiplied with 3. Then 72. Then you factorize 72, divisible by 2, 36, then 2, 18, then 2, 9, then 3, 3. So 72 is equal to 2 to the power 3 multiplied with 3 to the power 2. So our next number is 120. So factorize 120 here. So 2, 6, 0. Then 2, 30, then 2, 15, then 3, 5. So 120 is equal to 2 to the power 3 multiplied with 3 multiplied with 5. So next we have to find HCF. So HCF of 6, 72, 120 is equal to, so what is our HCF? The product of smallest power of common prime factors present in the numbers. So what is the common factors? 2 and 3. Then what is the smallest power of 2? So here 2 to the power 1. So we have to take 2 to the power 1. And next 3 is common factor. So what is the smallest power of 3? So here 3 to the power 1. So our HCF is 6. So here HCF is 6. So what is LCM? LCM of 6, 72, 120. So HCF is equal to product of highest powers of all the prime factors present in the numbers. So first factor is our 2. So 2 highest power is 3. Then multiplied with 3. 3 highest power is 4. Then 5, another factor is 5. So 5 power is 1. So this becomes 8 multiplied with 9 multiplied with 5. So this becomes 360. So this is the method known as prime factorization method to find the HCF and LCM of positive integers. One thing, earlier I told you that HCF, product of HCF and LCM of two numbers is equal to the product of two numbers. But here in case of three numbers, this is not true. In our previous example, we have found the LCM by using that rule. Here in case of three numbers, you cannot use that rule. That is, the HCF of 3 numbers multiplied with LCM of 3 numbers is not equal to the product of that 3 numbers.